Hey guys, Ben Taylor here, and welcome to another Tuesday tutorial. Today, it's absolutely boiling. So if you see me sweating, I can only apologise. I need to get a fan in this room really bad. Today, we're going to be getting hands-on in Lightroom. In particular, we're going to be editing with something called the Tone Curve. Now, this is probably one of Lightroom's most powerful tools. And as soon as you've learned how to use this, you can apply it to all your images to start getting some really great results. So without further ado, let's jump into today's tutorial and get started. Thanks for joining me today for today's video, guys. I really want to give you a warm welcome. And if you haven't watched these videos already, I'm going to encourage you to kind of start watching them. And if you like them, then please subscribe to the channel. Here, we're all about photography, Lightroom, and Photoshop. So if you love that kind of thing, then why not join like-minded people who are really passionate about what they learn? So today's tutorial is focusing on the tone curve. And surprisingly, this is something which a lot of people that use Lightroom don't actually use, but they're missing out on probably one of the most powerful tools in Lightroom. This can be a real asset when you're editing your photos from start to finish. So enough talk from me, let's jump into today's tutorial so I can show you guys what you can do to improve your photos in Lightroom. Okay, so let's get started. This is the image that we're going to be working with today to really show you how you can use a tone curve to get some great results. As always with my tutorials, you'll be able to find this downloadable in the YouTube description under the video. Okay, so what we're focusing on today is the tone curve. This is a great tool for making changes to your photos in Lightroom. Where can it be found? Well, the develop module is where the tone curve can be found. So if you're on the library module here, all you want to do is flick over to the develop module. You can do that by clicking on it, or alternatively press D, which is a shortcut on your keyboard. Then on the right hand side, you'll see a bunch of options. These are different ways that you can edit your image. Now, the second one down is the tone curve. So click on that, and then you'll see this square box here with a line which runs through the middle. Now, don't worry, it might look like something you'll have no idea what to do with, but I'm going to take you through a step-by-step way which you can learn it, so it's going to be easy for you to understand. Okay, so the very easiest way to start off learning the tone curve is to come down, and at the moment we're on the point curve, which is this one here. But there's actually another option in the tone curve, which can be found right here. So if we click on this, this is going to bring up the region curve, which is here. Now the region curve is an easy way to start understanding the way the tone curve works. And that's because it tells you the different areas which the tone curve, which is this line here, affects. So we've got highlights here, we've got lights, darks, and shadows. Now what's even better about the tone curve is that you've got these sliders which you can just push up and down, and they will affect the highlights by making them lighter or darker. And even better, you can see this reflected on the actual line itself which runs through the tone curve. Up here you can see that when you hover over the highlights, it actually shows you which area you're going to be affecting. So let's just start putting this into action. So let's say we want to make the highlights a bit darker. All you need to do is drag this here and then pull it down, and this is going to make your highlights a bit darker. You can see that reflected on the curve. You can push it up, that's going to make your highlights lighter, and you can also see this reflected in the image. Then if we come down to lights, you can see the area changes on the line, and then it's showing you which part of the line you're going to be affecting. So we can pull the lights down to make them darker, and we can push them up to make them lighter. You can do this with the other two areas as well, darks and shadows. So this is a really great way of learning how to use the tone curve and which areas it affects. Now, a great thing to do is, as soon as you've had a little play around with this and you've got used to how to use it, it's then good to go on to the point curve. And this can be found here. So let's click on this. And this is going to take us back to the place that we were at the start. Now, you might be looking at this and thinking, well, kind of how do I change this? It's just a line which runs through the middle. Well, the point curve enables you to put certain points on it to change different areas and make them lighter or darker, just like we'd learned in the region curve. So a good way I find for beginners to learn this is by putting three points on. You put one point here, which is in your dark area. You put one here, which is in the midtones, and one here, which is in the lights. This now gives us five different areas to change on the curve. So for instance, we have our shadows, our darks, midtones, lights, and highlights. Okay, so we've got the points on our tone curve now. It'd be a good time to really look at the image and focus on the changes that we want to make. So, I don't know if you agree with me, but this, I think, is a beautiful image. But there is something lacking in the image, and that is contrast. The image is very flat, and, you know, it's not kind of really drawing you in because there's no separation between the colours. So we want to add more contrast into this image. And the perfect tool to use to add the contrast is the tone curve. So what would we do? Well, contrast is about separating the lights and the darks and the colours. So we want to start here in the darks and drag them down to make them darker. And then push up the highlights to make them lighter, like that. And you can see we've now added contrast in the lights and darks of the image. Now let's just take a look at the before and after so we can see the changes we've made. All you need to do is hit the backslash key on your keyboard. So this is the before and this is the after. So we've added more contrast into the image and it now looks a lot more pleasing on the eye. Now I think we can actually add a bit more contrast in, so I'm going to drag this down a bit more in the darks here. And I'm going to push the highlights up just a little bit more. And finally, I think this area here, which is the midtones, I think we can actually make that a little bit darker as well, just so it stands out a bit more. And now let's have a look at the before and after. This is the before, and this is the after. The image looks a lot better already. So this is just one small change we've made with the tone curve, which has really brought this image to life. But there is so many different possibilities you have that you can use with the tone curve. Let's move on to another image quickly. So this image here, which can also be found in the description area on YouTube, you can download that as well. Now in this picture, it's a bit different because it's already really dark and very contrasty. I quite like the look of the image the way it is. But if you wanted to change it and you wanted to flatten the image a bit, because it's a bit too contrasty, say, for your liking, you could do this really easily with the tone curve. Now, there's a few ways you can do this. You could make it flatter by bringing up your shadows and making them brighter, and then bringing down the highlights slightly. And then if we have a look at the before and after, you can see now that we've took this image, which was really contrasty, and made it flat like this, which just means there's less contrast between the colours. If we press reset, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some different ways that you can use the tone curve in now. Take a look at these. These are going to be different ways you can use it to really make some cool changes to your pictures. So the tone curve is not just about making changes to the lights and darks in your image. You can do more. So if we come back to our first image here, We've got this picture here, which is now looking a lot better because we applied contrast with our tone curve. But we could even take this up another notch, because you can see in the background, it's a beautiful, warm scene, but we can make this look even warmer. Now, the way we do this is we can change the channel on our tone curve here, and we can swap this over to colors. So all you have to do is click the drop down here, and then we have more options. We have red, green, and blue. Now, we want to add warmth into this image. To do that, we need an orange color, but we've only got red, green, and blue. Well, that's no worry at all, because if we click on red, push up the red here in the middle, add it to the mid-tones, and then if we come back on here and then go to the blue, the opposite of blue is yellow. So let's drag that down, and then now we have this really nice warm orange color in the image. So red and yellow make orange. You can see how much a powerful effect this has made to the image. Let's have a look at the start here and then the after. We've really transformed the look of this image and then really made it a lot better. So as you can see, the tone curve is a really powerful tool which you should definitely add into your editing. And it's actually quite easy to use. All you need to do is spend a little bit of time practicing with it so that you can get better and more accustomed how to use it. So I really hope you've enjoyed this video today, guys, about the tone curve. Remember, this is a great tool and you should definitely start adding it into your workflow in Lightroom so that you can really get some powerful edits. Now, if you want to carry on learning about Lightroom, then I'm going to leave some tutorials over here, or maybe some over here. It's a bit like a dance, doesn't it, Matt? You can carry on watching them and learning Lightroom, because I've made these videos for you to enjoy. Now, I spend a lot of my time making these videos, so I'd really appreciate something just like a thumbs up, or maybe leave me a comment to let me know I've done a good job, and I'd really appreciate that. And whatever you do today, guys, I hope you have a great day, and please come back again really soon.